I have this responsibility being at home that I have to make one meal every day, whether it is breakfast, lunch or dinner. तो आज मुझे बोला गया सुबह में कि शाम को आपको कुछ बनाना है. You know, I have to make something for dinner. So I thought I'll make some kebabs.
Wow.
So now this kebab reminds me of kebabs that we have done in Spectra, if you remember, in one of the brunches.
Yes, I had it myself the other day, chef. And I was just praising it, praising the recipe because it's so simple and
one of the Sundays, Ritika, if you remember, we did a lot of regional food in Spectra.
Yeah.
And we have been focusing a lot on regional cuisine in Spectra, on especially on brunches.
Yes.
So now since we all are in this lockdown state, so the vegetables and grocery and everything is very very limited. So hamare yahan pe where I stay, there's this vegetable vendor who comes on a daily basis.
Okay.
So kal wo sweet potato yani ki shakarkandi lekar aaya tha.
That's so,
I thought I'll do a kebab of shakarkandi, but I'll give it a small little twist. It's more like a hack that people can use from their refrigerators in these days, because the idea is not to throw anything. So I'm going to use that. I'm going to show you. All right. So let's begin. Let me just show you the ingredients that I have.
Okay.
So that's the sweet potato that I have. All right.
Which you have boiled.
Yeah, I have just boiled the sweet potato. No salt, nothing, just plain water. Then I have some coriander stems, because usually this goes waste in the kitchen, but since I have been a part of it these days, so kuch fekna nahi hai. Some chili, some lemon.
Okay.
Then I have some brown onion. Yeah, so what I've done is I've just shallow fried some onions and made them crispy.
Okay.
Yeah, so we're going to add that in the recipe as well. And then I have some chana powder with me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that's the basic ingredients that I have. Now, what small little twist I am doing is, मैंने संडे को छोले भटूरे बनाए थे घर पे.
Okay.
तो मेरे पास संडे के छोले बचे हुए रखे हैं.
Okay.
So I bought boiled chana और छोले. So I thought I'm going to use that leftover choles in this recipe.
Okay.
How does that sound? Nothing goes as a waste.
I'm helping myself, and I tried it yesterday, so I know that it's an amazing day.
Let's try that. So I have some chole from the fridge. So what I will do is, first of all, let me lower down my music, because I just can't work without music in my kitchen.
Okay. Chef, but in the recipe that you do for the Sunday brunches, this is an alteration from the regular recipe, right?
Yeah, every Sunday, we focus on vegetarian and non-vegetarian kebabs. Mm-hmm. But Shakarkandi ke kebab was one of the favorites when winters were there. Because during that time, garma garam shakarkandi khane mein bada maza aata hai, halka sa roast karke koile ke upar neembu aur kala namak dal ke. So now, in these days, the idea is to not throw anything, like I said. So maine kya kiya, shakarkandi ka base liya hai, and I'm added chole to that. Because chole are natural binding, any chana or any lentil is a natural binding agent. So ab pure kebab ko bind karne ke liye aapko kya chahiye? So I was thinking ki main alag se kuch uske liye main taiyari karu, ya mere fridge mein kuch pada ho.
Okay.
So then I found out that chole bache hue, let's try that. And honestly, I've never tried this version myself.
Okay.
So one of the important aspects is also to do trial and error in your own kitchen. So I'll take a blender, and I'll put this chana into the blender.
Okay.
Now what I've done is, मैंने जो चने बचे हुए थे उसको एक बार पहले मैंने boil कर लिया दोबारा से हाई हीट पे, तो उसका पानी मैंने सारा सुखा दिया. द आइडिया इज दैट इसके अंदर वाटर नहीं होना चाहिए. सो वी विल टेक दैट एंड देन वी विल जस्ट रफली चॉप आवर स्वीट पोटैटो. सो यू सी दिस, जस्ट रफली कट, एंड आई एम गोना ऐड एवरीथिंग इनटू इट. तो हम क्या करेंगे, इसको ब्लेंड मारेंगे.
ओके.
करेक्ट. नाउ आइडियली आप चाहे तो स्वीट पोटैटो को ग्रेट भी कर सकते हैं, बट सिंस हमारे पास चने हैं जिसके अंदर ऑलरेडी थोड़ा सा पानी है, तो इसलिए मैं ब्लेंडर यूज कर रहा हूँ, विच इज ऑल्सो अ लिटिल फास्टर वे ऑफ डूइंग इट. You see?
Okay.
Yeah. So more or less so equal
part of your version, your own version, and then you add it and the flavor to it.
Yes, yes. So mota moti I would prefer an equal quantity of sweet potato as well as chana. So we'll have to blend it and see how does it go towards it.
So, chef, this recipe that you're making is enough for how many people? You know, as in the service.
See now, whenever you make a kebab mixture, it is very difficult to portion out how many portions it will be. But from say half a kg, if you're taking a mixture of half a kg, you can easily churn out 15 to 20 pieces of kebabs.
Okay.
You know, so one kebab being a decent sized gallet, which is roughly 25 to 30 grams. So you can churn out 20 pieces more or less into that.
Okay.
I'm going to put into the blender.
Chef, could you turn the table? We would like to see how the preparation is going on.
Home, I'm also learning how to cook live as well as cook by myself with the same manpower. We don't have extra manpower. So we'll give it a blend. Kyunki ye thoda sa gaadha mixture hai, we'll have to constantly stir it. This will take a little bit. छोले में हमारे ऑलरेडी मसाले हैं, टेक्निकली अगर आप देखें तो छोलों में ऑलरेडी मसाले हैं. सो वी हैव टू सी वंस वी मिक्स एवरीथिंग, उस मोमेंट पे अगर हमको स्पाइसेस की जरूरत लगती है देन वी विल बैलेंस इट.
ओके, बट इफ यू आर डूइंग दिस विद बॉइल्ड छोले एंड नॉट अ कुक्ड मिक्सचर, देन व्हाट ऑल स्पाइसेस डू यू ऐड?
सो आई एम गोना गो टुवर्ड्स द स्पाइसेस in the end. Let me just blend this.
Okay.
Okay. तो इसका जो कंसिस्टेंसी है वो जब हलवा बनता है घर पे, तो हलवा जब ठंडा हो जाता है तो कैसी कंसिस्टेंसी होती है, यू नो, इट इज मोर लाइक गुई टेक्सचर. नाउ स्वीट पोटैटो इज नथिंग बट ओनली कार्बोहाइड्रेट एंड स्टार्च, सो द थिकनेस विल ऑटोमेटिकली कम फ्रॉम स्वीट पोटैटो. So, see, I'm going to show you now. See, that's how the mixture looks like.
Okay.
Yeah. So it is pretty hard and thick, but it still has some chunk of sweet potato, which we will mash it from hand eventually. जब हम इसका पूरा मिक्सचर हम तैयार करेंगे, right?
But do you grind it very finely, chef, or do you want to keep it a little coarse so that you know it's like when you have it to kill the chunk?
Yeah, I would keep it a little chunky because to mash sweet potato and chickpeas is little difficult. And I mean, if you keep it chunky, वो जो bite मुंह में आएगा ना, so that would also make it very interesting.
Yeah, true.
So I'm just chopping my coriander stem. I love coriander stem because that is the actual flavor space that is there. हम usually पत्ते इस्तेमाल करते हैं, सुंदर बनाते हैं ना, garnish करते हैं और stems को फेंक देते हैं.
Yeah.
But you should never ever throw stems in your own kitchen. You can do multiple things with that. You can make a stock with that. You can make a soup with that.
Okay.
You can chop it and put it in your kebabs. You can do a lot many things with the coriander stem. So do you also cook at home, Ritika?
Chef, like I told you, you know, I tried this recipe yesterday, and you know, this is the first time that I did, and you know, I loved the version. I had it with family chutney, so
So how often do you cook, or you just like to eat?
Chef, I love to eat actually. I am very lazy when it comes to cooking, which is why I wanted some simple versions of you know, recipes which you can cook very easily, which take very less time. So
see, people throw this. Look at that.
Yeah,
this is full of flavors.
The actual flavor lies.
This is burst of flavors, trust me.
Yeah.
I mean, you boil water, you put this, you put salt, and you put a black pepper, you have your vegetable broth ready, only coriander broth.
Wow. That's quite an interesting
taste. So how much of coriander are you chopping for the kebab?
Around about 50 grams. Okay.
You know, in a mixture of 400 to 500 grams of entire mixture, I usually add 50 grams, but coriander is something that the more you add, the less it is. So you can feel free to add as much as you want.
Okay.
All right. Okay. So that's how it looks like.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now you mix it up all together.
I'll mix it up. But what I'm also doing is I'm also adding a makai ka atta to it.
Okay.
Now, makai ka atta is corn flour basically. Now, this gives a little sweetness to the entire recipe, and it also binds the entire thing.
Okay.
Yeah, it is already very sticky. But
so, chef, you know, makai, as I said, you know, it's a little sweet, and sweet potato in itself, you know, is a very sweet kind of a, you know, interesting flavor to it. So, don't these two flavors, you know, make it even sweeter, or how do you balance them out?
See, any which ways, we're going to add some spices to it.
Okay.
And this flour is not very sweet. It has the natural sweetness from the corns itself. You know, so nothing that actually makes it very, very sweet. Okay. So I will just take the blender one more time. I'm going to take my onions, you know, so all of them, I will just give a nice mix to it.
The brown onion,
usko sirf ek bar main blender mein usko halka sa churn kar lunga. So it's easier for me to mix it in the mixture. That, you know, it is like a paste. Yeah, because it has been shallow fried in oil, so when you blend this, oil also mixes in the onions.
Yes.